What's up, you beautiful bastards? Hope you're having a fantastic Tuesday. Welcome back to the Philip DeFranco Show, and let's just jump into it. And the first thing we're going to talk about today is Starbucks and cancer, kind of. So if you don't drink coffee at Starbucks, or you do not live or have not visited the state of California, you may not know. Starbucks and other coffee retailers in the state have been required to advertise a cancer warning. Just that good old Proposition 65 warning over at the mixing station. A little cream and sugar with your cancer juice, he said sarcastically. Now at this point, a good number of you are probably thinking, wait, does coffee cause cancer? Well, in 2018, according to the World Health Organization, there is, quote, inadequate evidence that drinking coffee causes cancer based on a review of more than 1,000 studies. But coffee includes acrylamide, so according to California law, it had to have a cancer warning, something that a California judge last spring backed up. But the news today is all of that is set to change. According to reports, thanks to an assessment from California's Office of Environmental Health Hazard Assessment, California has determined that coffee does not contain enough acrylamide, a chemical produced when coffee is roasted, to be listed with a cancer warning under Proposition 65. And for the most part, that means two main things. Firstly, as of October 1st, the exception will be put into place, and so the places that sell coffee will no longer be required in the state of California to have that cancer warning. And two, it's very likely that this story will hurt a number of lawsuits. Specifically, the more than 90 coffee retailers out there who are being accused of knowingly selling coffee with a carcinogen. Although, of course, we're gonna have to wait to see if that actually does happen. Also, a note that I do wanna hit on. I know some non-Californians watching this video are like, wait, so people were still buying the coffee even though it was like, this may cause cancer? Yes, and there is a joke to be made about how much people need their coffee. But if you're in California and you just look around, there are a lot of these warnings all over the place. And that's because acrylamide is just one of 900 ingredients on a specific list that businesses have to put warnings up about. So for the most part, I think people just see it, they got used to it, and then everyone ignores it. You know, that's just kind of human nature. But yeah, there was that. And then let's cover the heavily requested story of Deji and KSI, but only kind of. If you don't know, these two are brothers. They're very large creators on this platform and others. But for the most part, this story is just drama. There's barely a legal aspect to it, a money aspect to it. Whenever we cover a story, something I ask myself and of my team is why? And there is a conversation that could be had around drama videos, because when we look to these people online, myself included, a lot of people don't see them as real people, especially when that person maybe has been at the center of many dramas, storied dramas. We kind of just assume that it's fake or someone's playing something parallel to a character and someone's not actually getting hurt or being manipulated. And for the most part, this story could be boiled down to Deji made a lot of claims that KSI was abusive, that he assaulted him, he felt constantly pressured or intimidated. Ultimately, and keep in mind, I'm oversimplifying things, KSI said a lot of things were misrepresented. He also provided video evidence. For other things, he apologizes or adds context. And so in general there, I don't give a damn. But where I did become interested is because Logan Paul became involved, and it created a money slash legal slash also accidental fake news situation. So in the midst of all this drama, after KSI uploaded his video, where as of recording right now, he has 4.7 million views on it, KSI tweets, "If you don't see ads, it's because it's being claimed by Logan Paul's network." And it appears it's because in that video, KSI uses footage of Deji on Logan Paul's podcast. To that KSI tweet, Logan Paul responded, "Ha ha ha, fuck you pussy," which wasn't the best of looks for Logan Paul, since being someone who claims someone else's video because they use a small clip makes you look like a giant asshole. Also, it would put Logan and his team on the wrong side of a fair use debate. But the main reason was because KSI said that all the money from that video, it would go to two suicide prevention charities. So ultimately, optic-wise, you have the guy that's still known to some people as the Suicide Forest guy monetizing a video where the money was going to go to suicide prevention charities. It's not very maverick of you, some would argue. But on this note, it does look like the claim was automatic. It was not done intentionally by Logan. Logan removing the claim and kind of apologizing. Later tweeting, "Really jumped the gun on that one. I'll make sure the automatic claim is removed. KSI is still a pussy though. Staying on brand." But also, there were still people upset saying it's still ridiculous that Logan Paul did this during that time that the video was claimed. That money's now not going to go to suicide prevention charities. And so there's that little bit of fake news that's been going around, and I just want to hit on that note. That's not how it works. If Logan Paul and his team had maybe blocked the video, stripped it of ads, then yes, the money would not have been made. But based on the screenshot that KSI posted, it looked like it was monetized by the claimant, Logan. And essentially the way that works on YouTube is ads still play, and until a dispute is settled, the money doesn't go to anyone. So all the money that was still made during that time can still go to the suicide prevention charities. But I guess the main point of this story is I didn't care about 85% of it, and KSI and Logan, it would be great if you guys punch each other in the head a bunch for everyone's entertainment and you'd make a lot of money again. Okay, great, moving on now. Thank you for the thumbnail. And from that, I wanna share some stuff I love today and today in awesome brought to you by Ruggable. And for those unfamiliar, Ruggable rugs are machine washable, waterproof, stain resistant, and not to mention stylish and completely affordable. Ruggable sent me two of their rugs to try out, and I cannot recommend them enough. One we put in our living room and it's been a lifesaver, because with two kids and a lot of foot traffic, my rugs at home get so dirty so fast. And so now just having something that I can just throw in the washer, forget about, it's unbelievably convenient. And the other rug that they sent to the office is one of my favorite designs on the site, even though, yes, I know, it looks like a design of a shirt I've definitely worn on this show before. But main point, whether you're dealing with messy kids, pets, just prone to spilling things everywhere like myself, Ruggable is your answer. And part of it is that their patented two-piece system with the cling effect technology makes it non-slip. And of course, on top of everything, the top is extremely easy to remove, whether it's for washing or just changing out designs. And best of all, for you beautiful bastards going, yeah, I want to snag a new rug, make sure you click the link in the description or type in myruggable.com/DeFranco and then enter code DeFranco15 for 15% off your entire purchase today. And the first bit of awesome, if you know, you know. If you don't worry about it. I just want to take a quick moment to give a little shout out, a little love to the weirdos over at Sugar Pine 7. I don't know a lot of the details, but you're my favorite weirdos, whoever just completely fucked me over for a Streamy Award. I love you faces. I wish you the best. And just remember, as long as you keep trying to create and achieve something that you want to achieve, this feels big now, but one day this will feel a million miles away. And just like everything else, it'll just have been something that happened. And that's not to discount what is happening, but just mentioning that. So it does not break you slash lead to you breaking down. Then we got a clip from the new movie Late Night. We got the launch trailer for Effie. First We Feast gave us a trailer for season 4 of The Burger Show. Ted Ed gave us how light technology is changing medicine. We got the official teaser trailer for some Jurassic World animation goodness. And then our chrono.gg/Phil partner game of the day today is Dying Light and or the Enhanced Edition Plus Gunslinger DLC. On a personal note, I really love the game. I personally enjoyed the DLC. Best of all, if you use our link down below before 9 a.m. tomorrow while stock lasts, you can snag this normally $62.98 bundle for just $17.50, or if you just want the base game, you can get that for $14.99. And if you want to see the full versions of everything I just shared, the secret link of the day, really anything at all, links as always are in the description down below. Then let's talk about what's something controversial we could talk about. We've talked about politics, we've talked about abortion rights, religions, each their own. Moving on. I'm kidding. But joking aside, as you may have seen, there is a Catholic bishop in the center of a big news story right now, specifically Providence Bishop Thomas Tobin, who over the weekend tweeted, a reminder that Catholics should not support or attend LGBTQ Pride Month events held in June. They promote a culture and encourage activities that are contrary to Catholic faith and morals. They are especially harmful for children. For children. For children. And I will say, as a former Catholic, there is nothing that the Catholic Church cares about more than the children. Although I will note, I stopped being a Catholic before I even heard about any of that. Longtime viewers of the show know, I think I was like 7 to 10, somewhere in there. I went to a Catholic school. I had a conversation with a Catholic priest and he said that my dogs would not go to heaven with me. It was just for humans. And I was like, this isn't for me. I saw a movie that disagrees with you, sir. Let's agree to disagree. It's not a real thing, I said. I was like 7. You know, I thought to my 7-year-old self, if Smokey can't go to heaven, I don't want to go either. But main point, Thomas Tobin wanted people to think of the children and not support LGBTQ events. Following this, much of the internet responded, and I will say, they said this in a less PC way, given the Catholic Church's well-documented and now even still more coming out abuses of children. It's probably best you don't try and act all high and mighty that you're promoting good, especially when the main point of what you're saying is don't accept those people. Or I guess we gotta include some of the comments. A very popular one from Comment Etiquette Red. Am I too late in here to say you people fuck kids? I told you I was cleaning up the language. Ethan Klein of the fantastically popular H3 podcast tweeting, reminder that the Catholic Church is responsible for the systemic sexual abuse of thousands of children, and if there is one place I wouldn't want my children to be, is alone with a Catholic priest. Some also seeming to share personal stories, like one user who wrote, he oversaw the man who abused many in my community, including my husband in the 80s and 90s, being redeployed to a church in Jersey City with a school attached. He wasn't removed from ministry by Tobin until late 2018. Although that isn't to say that Bishop was met with only backlash. There were those that agreed with him, including Bishop J. Strickland, who tweeted, please stop labeling bishops who speak the truth of the gospel as homophobic. God gave us sexual intimacy for the procreation of children and the deeper union of a man and woman in marriage. Stating this truth is not homophobia, it is simply reality. And following that up with, we live in an age when many revel in the supposed end of the Catholic faith and the truth Jesus Christ died to share. All who are reveling, I pray for you. If you still believe, I hope these simple words bring strength. As one bishop, I will do my best to, quote, pray more and worry less. As far as my reaction to this story, seeing this coming from these bishops, it's not surprising, it is frustrating. That said, I don't want to completely villainize religion or people that have faith. I know plenty of religious people, including Catholics, who are fantastically nice and appreciative, and they don't other people because of the way they were born or how they choose to live their life, as long as they're not hurting other people. But when you have people with this immense power, with this institution that is perceived as having a connection to the highest
power.
Telling people, telling their followers to not support their fellow man or woman because of the way that they were born. Also, side note, if you're one of these people that thinks that it's like, it's a choice to be gay, bi, whatever, I don't even know where the hell to put all your stupid. Doing well for myself, but I don't have the square footage for that. And I think one of the reasons that this disgusting thing frustrates me so much is that we then see bishops like Strickland framing the narrative as that he is the victim, right? Framing the people who are angered by all of this as those reveling at the failure of the Catholic faith. I and many others are not reveling in this the supposed end of the Catholic faith. People not accepting you telling others to not accept and support people because of the way that they were born is not you being persecuted or is not you being discriminated against. And to Bishop Strickland, who ended that tweet saying, "Pray more and worry less." I pray that something can lead you and others like you to be more accepting. But unfortunately, till then, myself and definitely others who this impacts on a more direct basis, we, but specifically they, cannot worry less because there are people like you spouting what you're spouting. But that's where I'm gonna end this one today. If you have any thoughts on any of the stories, I'd love to see them in the comments down below. Also, based on some of the comments that pop up on these videos now and then, I know that some of you, this is gonna be your last video. Welcome that dislike, I welcome that unsubscription. Thanks for the time beforehand, but yeah. I feel like our day-to-days are probably better off without one another. I think that's the nicest way I can say that. And that's where we're going to end today's show. Thanks so much for watching. Of course, if you're not 100% filled in, you can click or tap right there to catch up on shows you may have missed. But with that said, of course, as always, my name's Philip DeFranco. You've just been filled in. I love yo faces, and I'll see you tomorrow.